Hi, TrueFit professional here, Adrian Fryer, and one of the questions we're often asked in this short game scenario by many amateurs is, well, what club should I use? Should I stick to one club with one stroke, or should I vary my stroke and vary the club, and so on? Well, the first thing you need to understand about short game, and this depends on your skill level as to how big your repertoire of shots is, but the lie of the ball and what's facing you really gives you a clue as to which club is best to use. I've got three scenarios here. One where I've got to chip it over a bunker and land it onto this fairly fast green here at TrueFit. And another one where I've got to navigate a little hump. And then one where I'm close to the edge of the green. The first thing you need to assess with any of these shots is how the ball is lying. If the ball is sat down, you are probably going to need a steeper angle of attack. You're going to need to hit down on it more. If the ball's sat nicely, you can brush it more with more of a stiff-wristed stroke. So the lie initially intimates what stroke is required. Then you're looking at a couple of other issues. How much room have I got to navigate before I get onto the green? And then how much room and landing area have I got before the ball then runs out to the flag? In this instance, I've got to carry it quite away, then land it quite soft onto the green and let it run down. So it's necessary that I'm going to loft it. So in this instance, I'm going to be using my most lofted wedge. In this case, it's a 58 degree lob wedge or sam wedge. I'm going to need a slightly longer stroke, because the ball is going to spend more time in the air. In my mind, I'm picturing my flight and roll ratios. The ball generally bounces about three times before it rolls for most of your chip shots, if you study that. So in this case, I may want to throw it 70% of the way and it run 30. So I've got to pick my landing spot and calibrate that. So let's give this one a little go. It's quite a tricky one off a downhill lie. So that's not too bad there, rolling up to a puttable distance. I've thrown that quite high and soft and it's just going to run down. Now let's try this next one. So now I've got a little bit of room to navigate, but a bit more green to work with here. I don't have to navigate it over. So I'm going to go now for my normal pitching wedge, which is a little bit less loft, about 52 degrees. My roll with this is probably about 50-50 in terms of percentage of flight and roll. Now I'm going to land this on the front edge and let it run down. So that was quite nice, about 50% flight, 50% roll. And finally, I'm faced with one now on the front edge. There's nothing in front of me, no obstacles to go over, so all I really need to do here is just loft it onto the front edge and let the weight of the ball do the rest. So in this case, I've now elected to use a straighter faced iron. There's no real need to loft it. Almost like a glorified putt. This might be a third carry and two thirds roll. Selection, probably all you really need to do is master three clubs, and that would get you around most shots on a golf course. Assess the lie, pick your landing spot, learn your flight and roll ratios, and with a bit of practice, I'm sure you'll find your short game will be much more accurate.